But other countries, including Japan and Vietnam, the number of the publication is low and stable. That's I think this is we have many opportunity to increase this number. And recently, evidence-based medicine is the best evidence in making decision, but it is involving to our daily practice. But EBM is not only meaning of the research evidence, but it's integrated the system of the your clinical experience and the patient demands and the best available research information with the quality. And this is the level of evidence. The highest one is meta-analysis and randomized controlled trials. And I'm going to talk about two sessions, and other study design will be discussed in the second session later. And most of the clinicians, the purpose of the clinical study is mainly to investigate the causal relationship and to evaluate the effect of interventions. So if you would like to do so, you need to remember about this simple flow, just a basic idea on clinical study. So exposure causes outcome. This is very simple but very important. So for example, like a smoking causes occurrence of COPD, delay of treatment increases risk of severity, and antiviral therapy causes a decreasing death. This simple exposure causes outcome. Please remember about this. Then, if you want to get started, so you need to remember about the elements of study. So in this first session, I'm going to talk about the research questions. So research question is can be a purpose of the study. It is clinical questions that researchers are trying to get answers from the clinical research. So research question that is differ from the questions in your daily practice. Like it seems like vaccination has no effect in preventing severity of infection. See, that's your daily question. But you need to convert to the research question from your daily questions. Like for research, daily question is like a value questions. So I feel that people who develop a disease, is a lifestyle is unhealthy. So if we convert to the research question, in the comparison between healthy people and the people with disease A, proportion of daily alcohol intake is different? Is salt intake different? Or in the questions in daily practice, like I feel that the drug B used to date is more effective than the new drug of A. So two research questions. In the comparison between patients who use drug A and B, is the improvement of the laboratory data different? Or are the number of the days of the hospitalization different? This is a research question. So this is developing a research question. You need to define PICO or PECO. So P means population, I intervention, and C comparison, and O outcome. So it depends on the study design. So if it will be the intervention, the exposure, so you need to compare, you need to put the comparison and outcome. So this is the example from our study is from the clinical preparedness for the severe pneumonia with highly pathogenic avian influenza H5N1. It's used to conduct it with the people in Bachmann Hospital. So our question of the daily practice was avian influenza has a rapid progression. If the time to access to the hospital on patient with H5N1 relates to the mortality, this is our daily question, but the research question, P is a patient with avian influenza infection. I, time to initiation of antiviral treatment in oceltamivir. C, patient who are treated early versus patient who are treated delay. O, mortality. So from this PICO, you need to make a one sentence research question. Very simple one. Then you can make a hypothesis. Early initiation of antiviral treatment would reduce mortality on patients with H5N1 infection. So from this PICO, you can when you back to your home today, maybe you can develop your research question from PICO, put the PICO or PECO. Then five conditions that if you define the PICO or PECO, you need to test for the FINEL test. It's five conditions of the research question should satisfy feasible, interesting, novelty, ethical, and relevant. So feasible is including a number of subjects. So it depends on the PICO. You need to estimate the sample size and the technical expertise, and cost and time and money is okay, or scope. And if the first time of your research, do not make a too big scope. The beginning of the study should narrow at the beginning. So interesting. So interesting is very much important for, and especially, so maybe the motivation for the conducting a clinical research is you'd like to have a PhD degree or getting research grant or a promotion. But also scientific interest is lead to a strong motivation to complete your study plan and its expansion. So this is very much important. And novelty, so it is crucial reviewing literature whether there is novelty in your research question throughout by yourself. So maybe you know the PubMed, sometimes you can use a Google Scholar conducted by Google. So these were the free research engine for researching the literatures. So please do by yourself, and you can look at review the previous studies. Then ethical. A good research question must be ethical and relevant. So this one is important, and how the outcome obtained from your research contribution to the enhancement of the medical science, daily clinical practice, patient care, and public health in Vietnam and worldwide. So finally, you need to ask by yourself, so what? Your clinical research can contribute to the medicine, patient, social, public health, and the policy making. And so if you don't pass this so what test, so you can change the clinical question to conduct another study. So if your research question passed in a FINEL test and the so what test, so let's start to make your study plan. So study plan is including those kind of elements. So this is the final for the first session. Then I move on the second session to the study design. Okay. So study designing. So when you fix your research question and take our FINEL test and the so what test, and you need to make a study design. And you remember exposure causes outcome. So we put the hypothesis early initiation of antiviral treatment would reduce mortality on patients with H5N1 infection. From this hypothesis, what kind of study that you can conduct? What is the idea? So we set up the PICO, and my idea was when H5N1 patients are hospitalized, investigating the days from the onset to the initiation of oseltamivir, divided into two groups, early or delay, compare the mortality rate between the groups. It's okay, but it seems like it takes a long time to analyze. So the second idea was review the patient chart and collect the data of the number of the days from the onset to the initiation of oseltamivir, and compare the clinical outcome, death or survive, between the patient who initiated oseltamivir early or delay. So maybe okay, we can conduct. And the third idea is collect the information about the H5N1 patient in Vietnam who admitted to the hospital during the certain period of time, divided into two groups, survivors and non-survivors, then compare the prevalence of patients with H5N1 who treated with oseltamivir early or delay, and between survivors and non-survivors. Maybe if we can collect the whole data from Vietnam, we can conduct this study. So all of the things that I would like to say that even if the one research question, there's many methods to conduct the research. So you need to make a study design. So for the clinical study, mainly divided by the observational study and the intervention study. Then basic idea was exposure causes outcome. So depends on the where your eye is, the research design is different. You see the whole time progression, disease clinical disease course, or a certain period of time, or you need to see the back. So it depends on where you are. So one of the major study design of the observational study is a cohort study. Cohort means Roman term for a group of soldiers that marched together. You know, if soldiers marched together, enemies come and kill you. Then, so one were killed by enemies. And when they get the goals, some people already die, or some people still survived. This is the concept of the cohort study. So cohort study has a prospective study and a retrospective study. I'm talking about today for the prospective study. So follow up the group of people with and without factor, risk factor or exposure, and to elucidate the causality between the factor. So to see this people exposed and not exposed, and see the 10 years later, and see counted the number of the people who die or targeted outcome. So this is one example. For this is a we call marshmallow test. It's learned by the people in Stanford University. They put the 4 years old kids in a room with a sweet marshmallow, looks so delicious. And then so tell them, investigator, stay here, not to eat marshmallow until we come back. So at this moment, exposure is 8 marshmallow versus not to 8 marshmallow. Then they follow up these kids, and they finally got the result, and people who didn't eat marshmallow, to eat marshmallow, get high degree, high income, and high working position. Very successful. It's life. So this is a cohort study. So the cohort study is from the total population, select the participants who have a risk factor and not have a risk factor. Then follow up, and then so once they reach the date period, and we can count for the people number of the people who disease or out of who got the outcome. So this condition is, we know the number of the patients who have a risk factor exposure or not exposure. Then calculate the outcome. This is a cohort study. So indicators, cohort study can calculate relative risk and attributable risk, and also incidence rate. Incidence rate is we calculate by the person time years. So this one is a show. The left-hand slide is a non-smoker and smokers, and right-hand side is non-smokers. So number from the participants for this study, number of the people who got lung cancer is the same four. However, we divided by the cumulative observational time until the get the outcome. So if so, the smokers, group of the smokers is incidence rate is 13 per 100 person time years. Then non-smoker is 7 per 100 person time years. That means we can understand that smoking is a risk factor for lung cancer. And next one is a cohort study. Case control study. Case control study is a set up the disease group and control group and compare the presence of exposure in the past. So indicator of the case control study is we use odds ratio instead of relative risk because we don't know the number of the people who have exposure but don't have exposure. But we just set up the number of the people who have a disease or not to have a disease. So we use odds ratio for the indicator for the case control study. And this is an example from our study with in Japan, and we put a TB patient, hospitalized TB patient, and compare with the healthy adult volunteers who were not suspected TB infection. So advantage of the case control study is a lot of information can be obtained quickly from relatively few subjects. But then maybe less expensive for conducting the study than cohort study. However, the easy to get the effect of the bias. So next one is a cross-sectional study. The cross-sectional study is you saw the one single point to you examine the one from the one single point. So if so, it depends on the time to examination. Exposure and disease, number of the exposure and disease are different. So the time point is very much important.
Okay.
So this is
we're at time now. Thank you.
No, I have 20 minutes. Because this one is the second session.
Yes, that's right. Huh? That's right, we're at time now. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry.
Second session. So risk factors of aspiration pneumonia in older adults. And this is a questionnaire survey. And the questionnaire survey is a questionnaire survey usually for the cross-sectional study. So questionnaire study is ability to prove causality is inferior to cohort study. So intervention study is just divided by the subject, allocate or either intervention or control. So maybe they said that time for that. So maybe I'd like to summarize. So cross-sectional study, select a patient, either they have a swallowing exercise or a pneumonia, and the case control study is put the patient pneumonia or a healthy volunteer. And the cohort study, we saw without exercise or with exercise, and then follow up the data. And randomized control study is allocate for the number of the patient to intervention or not intervention group and see. Then depends on the study evidence level is different, and higher many trophy that get the study design is a higher level of evidence. So when you back to the home, please getting started and question of your daily practice and research question, making study planning test seat. And conclusion, but even if there is a evidence level, let's start your clinical research with a study design as far as you can without caring to the evidence level. best research collaborators would make the would assist to make the successful evidence. Well, thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much, Associate Professor Toshi Manabe. We won't have time for questions now, but maybe people can ask her questions in the break afterwards. Thank you.